study Arata to learn while we are sleeping. What an interesting idea. You hit play on a video class, a course, or even an audiobook on your phone, next to your bed, and then you go sleep. The day after, you have already used 8 hours that you have slept to learn new things. Well, this idea sounds amazing. If you did that every day, you would be able to absorb around 240 hours of lessons per month. But does it really work? Is your brain able to passively absorb information while you're sleeping? In today's talk, we will see what part is true and what is a myth about learning while sleeping. Science says it is possible to learn while we are sleeping, but we can learn only so much. The concept of learning while we're sleeping is quite old. There are studies about sleep learning since 1914. And in short, although you can improve the quality of your sleep to strengthen your study, it is not possible to learn while you're sleeping. You will not learn all these subjects from school or college or grad school just by listening to the recordings of your lessons while you sleep. The actual learning only happens when our brain is actively involved in what we're studying. It is difficult enough to involve our brain in the learning process when we are awake. Imagine how hard it would be when we're sleeping. But the idea of learning something when we sleep should not be completely discarded. Recent studies have shown that it is possible to at least increase the performance of your memory while sleeping. And this put sleep learning back to the radar of the scientists again. When you sleep, your brain processes and consolidates some of the thousand pieces of information that you have received during the day. And when using some specific techniques, which we will cover later on, it is possible to improve this consolidation process and increase your learning performance a little bit. Notice that it is quite different from learning something new while you sleep. And this has already been tested by science. And the conclusion was that you don't actually learn anything new if you're truly sleeping. At most, you can hear something, but that still happens while you're still awake. So you're not really in deep sleep. Now, forgive me if I've ruined your expectations, but we're here just dealing with scientific evidence, and the science has already discarded the possibility of learning something new while we are sleeping. But it has been also science that has opened the door to new possibilities, which we can and we should explore. Increase your brain's performance while you sleep, consolidating the memories you have learned. When you sleep, your brain processes the experiences you have had during the day. This process basically consists in sending memories from your hippocampus, where all your memories are first stored, to your cerebral cortex, where the memories are stored for a longer time. We have already talked about the three types of memory in episode 18 from the Study Arata series. Basically, you have your sensory memory, your short-term memory, and your long-term memory. Sensory memory captures everything that you see and hear, smell and taste and touch. This stays in your memory for a few seconds, because it would be inefficient for your brain to remember all of that. When your brain detects more relevant information, your short-term memory or your working memory comes to action. Now, I would suggest that you don't think of short-term memory from the point of view of time, but from the amount of information that you can handle at a given time, which is more or less 7 pieces of information. Whatever is really important or shocking will be encoded in your brain as long-term memory. And these memories stay in your head for days or even years. Encoding needs to be an active process, and that is why we use intelligent memory hooks in the Intelligence Arata Academy course. In order to move something from your short-term memory to your long-term memory, your brain needs to be actively involved with that information. Now, how can you do that? For example, you could use mechanical repetition or pure memorization. You could also use a mnemonic technique. You could create links or stories. Any active memorization strategy will encode memories. Now, the sleep phase has a very important role in this process. During sleep, this information is consolidated in your brain. Nonetheless, while you are deeply sleeping, it is impossible to actively use your brain in a conscious process of encoding memories. Actually, you can't really involve your brain passively when you are truly sleeping. At most, you can use that short period of time between the moment you go to bed and the point you fall asleep to help you in the process of encoding information. Use memory triggers to remember during the night what you learned during the day. You can use part of your night to strengthen what you learned during the day. But how can we do that? Some of the methods that have been tested by science have given positive results. The first method is conditioning. In practice, conditioning is the only method that you can use without relying on apps or electronic devices. The idea of conditioning is to activate memory triggers in your sleepy brain so it remembers what you have studied during the day, strengthening your memorization. Those triggers can be smells or sounds. That means something that can be picked up by your senses, even when you're sleeping. Science has already proven that memory triggers actually work to consolidate memories while you sleep. So, in one of those experiments, two groups of people were told to play a memory game in which they had to memorize the position of different items on a grid. And while one of the teams was playing, a specific smell was released into the room. And later, both teams went to sleep with brain monitoring devices, and they received the same smell in that room when they were sleeping. The brain monitoring shows that the group who had received the smell during the game had more brain activity in the hippocampus and also other parts of the brain. And this is the type of activity that happens when we consolidate memories. And when they woke up, the participants of the group who had received the smell, they remembered 84% of the item's positions in the grid. Meanwhile, the group who received no smell was only able to remember 61%. That is a difference of 23% thanks to using smell as a memory trigger. In practice, you could do the same with music. Let's say that you listen to a certain type of music when you're studying. When you go to sleep, theory says that you should play the exact same music as it can become a trigger for your brain to consolidate the things that you have studied. The idea of using music as a trigger has also been proved to have a second method. Specific sounds can activate brain waves that help you to consolidate what you have studied. Physically speaking, consolidating memories happens through electrical activity in your brain that is specific, slow, and fluctuating. The second method to learn while sleeping tries to stimulate that electrical activity during sleep. And to do that, scientists try to put electrodes on volunteers' heads to stimulate those electrical currents, or improve the consolidation of memories during sleep. And the results are positive. But it is difficult to actually convince someone to receive electric shocks in their heads during the night just to obtain a small memory improvement. The same scientists have tried a less invasive method. Measuring the brain activity of the volunteers, scientists gave them headphones that played sounds that were synchronized with their brain waves. In theory, this could help you to consolidate what you learn even when you're sleeping, but to do this, we need to develop simple and accessible technology that is able to measure the brain activity and also to play sounds that are synchronized with our brain activity. It is possible to learn a bit of new languages when you're sleeping. Since they were able to activate triggers or consolidate memories, some scientists have also tried to find out if we could learn a new language by listening to conversations in other languages while we sleep. So here we have another study from 2017 that is showing that during sleep, some people were able to learn complex new sound patterns. Another study from 2019 made volunteers listen to sets of invented words that were associated with real words while they slept. Those sounds were played during the less deep phases of sleep for each participant. And we are not usually daydreaming during those phases. Upon awakening, volunteers were able to connect the words, showing that there was some kind of learning that happened during sleep. The monitoring of their brains showed that their hippocampus and other areas of the brain that are usually linked to language, they were active. Well, this shocked the scientists as it disproves what they believed about the hippocampus, which would have been able to learn only when conscious. So far, scientists consider that it is possible to get familiar with the sounds, with the tone, and the accent of a new language while sleeping. Perhaps you could even learn the meaning of some words. But most of the time, those are implicit memories. And very few people were able to remember and use them when needed. Neurofeedback can accelerate your learning process during sleep. Another technology gadget it tested with positive results involves neurofeedback. In Israel, a device picks up and accelerates the activity of your brain when you are awake. For example, when you are studying, and the device picks up brain activity similar to the nighttime process of consolidating memories, the device electrically stimulates your brain. This instant neurofeedback stabilizes your memories, as if you had already been asleep. I know that even today, this might sound like science fiction, but there are even some electronic headsets on the market, especially for high-performance activities like those of professional gamers. Now, be careful with those products, the marketing strategies of these products, because so far there is no solid scientific evidence that has been tested that you can really improve your cognitive functions by using those devices. Which, by the way, they're pretty expensive, and they are still in their initial phases. More than learning during sleep, you need a good night's sleep. The idea of learning while you sleep and using another 8 hours of your day to absorb new information is very appealing. But you have seen that, in practice, only so much can be done to obtain a small memory improvement during sleep. So instead of wanting to learn while you sleep, it might be better to focus on getting excellent nights of sleep to then improve your learning. During sleep, your body rests, your organism repairs the damage that it received during the day, and your memories are consolidated in your brain. If you go to sleep with the TV on after a heavy meal, or in an uncomfortable room with plenty of light, you see, there is so much that you can change. Your sleep nights can be widely improved. This effort will make you to achieve more results when you are actually learning, rather than trying to learn while you're sleeping. To improve your sleep, you can follow a few steps. First, make sure that you have an appropriate set of mattresses and pillows for your weight, your age, and specific physical condition. Then, you have to make sure to accommodate your room so it facilitates sleep. And this means absolute darkness, turning off all the electronic devices with light and setting the temperature to around 19 to 21 degrees Celsius. Try to leave your phone in another room. Put it into a drawer, with the screen looking down. Set up the Don't Disturb option to work every day during your sleep time. Avoid drinking caffeine and other stimulants after lunch. If you want to drink something, you can choose some relaxing drinks like chamomile tea or fruit juice. And when it's getting close to bedtime, you can avoid activities that keep you awake. The screen time should be limited, or at least use apps that reduce the white and blue light prominence. There is a lot that you can do to improve the quality of your sleep. There are practical actions that you can adopt today in order to sleep better and wake up refreshed to study. And this will really help you to learn more than trying to find a silver bullet that does all the work that you were unable to do during the day overnight. Is it possible to learn while sleeping? Well, actually, it is not. We still can't learn new things while we are in deep sleep. You have found out that the most you can do today in practice is to use memory triggers, like sounds or smells, to help out a little during the process of consolidating memories. The same smell that was present during your study sessions, it can be used as a trigger to activate your brain and help it to strengthen your memories during the night. Since the other options still depend on technologies that are not yet available, the best thing you can do now is to improve the quality of your sleep. By sleeping better, you consolidate what you have learned in a more efficient way, and then you wake up more refreshed to study even more. And if you want to know how to study more and better, I invite you now to watch a special lesson from the Intelligence Arata Academy course, which will show you how to exponentially increase your intelligence levels using science-proven techniques. To watch this special lesson, you can just go to arata.se/intelligence.